Please, we want you to reach out for your mobile phones and put them on silent or turn them off. Please, we will not appreciate any phones ringing when the service has commenced. The Lord be with you. We declare this service opened in the name of the Father, amen, and of the Son, amen, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
We sing together the first hymn on our program. That's our processional hymn. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. May we please rise as we sing together to honor the Lord.
I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we hallow your name, we exalt your name, we magnify your name, because you are our Father, you are our Lord, you are the King, you are the righteous one, you are the beginning, you are the end, you are the sustainer of life, you are the giver of life, you have been our hope, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come, a shelter in the storm, our eternal home. We give you praise because your word says in everything we should give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning us. We come this morning to appreciate you for the life you gave us in our brother, in your son, Mr. Akin Adeshokan. We thank you for the way he lived while here on earth. We thank you, Lord, for the lives he touched. We thank you, Father, because he made something out of life. And we thank you most importantly that he knew you and he served you. And so we return the glory back to you because you gave him the opportunity to live here on earth and to be an influence in many lives. And so, Lord, we say, receive all the praise and adoration in the name of Jesus Christ. We gather here this morning to celebrate this life and to surrender totally to you. We ask, Holy Spirit, you are the comforter. We ask that your presence will lead us through this worship experience in the name of Jesus Christ. That you will help us to see your presence and to feel your glory in this place in the name of Jesus Christ. That all that we shall do, we bring glory and honor to you alone, O Lord. That we shall be yielded unto you, we shall surrender unto you. Father, Lord, we pray that you will saturate this place with your presence. That no untoward situation will happen here in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, the Bible says the joy of the Lord is our strength. Let your joy be our strength in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, help us to know that for us to live is Christ and to die is gain. He has gained Christ, and so we have surrendered unto you and we are at peace because we know we shall see him again. And so, Father, we pray that everything we do this day will be in that consciousness. We ask for strength for the immediate family. We ask for strength for everyone that is here. And we ask, Holy Spirit, for the officiating ministers, that in everything we do, your name alone will be exalted. Have your way, O Lord, and take your place. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
We'll be singing two hymns. The first one is, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder. Then we'll go to Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow. We'll still remain standing as we sing this one. When we're singing the second hymn, we may be seated. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder.
Oh Lord, my God. Confidence now when Christ shall come.
When Christ shall come, we shout of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart when I shall come in all new adoration and then proclaim. Then sings my soul, my Savior God.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Please, you may be seated. To ask all our fathers in the house, all the men, let's sing as one together.
God send his soul, they call him Jesus, he came to love, heal and forgive, he lived and died to buy.
Everybody, tell us together.
The cross he lives, I can face tomorrow because he lives. All fear is gone because I know he holds the future and life is won.
Mothers,
how sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the
everybody, let's declare, because he lives.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds. He lives, I can face tomorrow because he lives. All fear is gone because I know.
We say amen together.
He is traveling wrong.
am down and oh my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart's burden be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on earth. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Church, I stand there under the direction of our chairperson, Mrs. Denele Kennedy, who is the chairperson of the Community Hymn Singing Group. I proudly serve under her as the vice chairman. It's so unique for us today because the person we are honoring is the father of the Community Hymn Singing Group in this church. There was nothing like that before until it dawned on our brother Akin, just by himself alone, he decided to come about this idea of forming this group. I don't know what criteria he used, but he single-handedly picked all the people you see in front of the casket, including myself, to be members of the Community Hymn Singing Committee. Typical of him, he did all this, but he never took any position. He forced Mrs. Kennedy to be the chairperson. And in my own case, he suddenly announced in one of the meetings that Air Vice Marshal Ombu will be the vice chairperson. Nobody protested. I knew I would never have won if there was an election. And the good thing is that there is no tenure. So almost 5 years after, here I am. And it's indeed a privilege. For 25 years, I was worshiping in the other church as what you would call a backbencher. I would love to come to the church quietly, worship, and go home. On this particular day, Brother Akin called me. I didn't even know he had my number. And by the way, anybody who worships in this church will know Akin. From the moment you enter, Akin is there to welcome you. Inside the church, Akin hardly sat down. He's carrying the tray for communion. He will help with the tithes. He will make sure you are comfortable. The only thing I haven't seen Akin do in my years of serving here was to hear him preach the sermon. So that day he called me, and let me just share this with you. He told me about this community hymn singing, which in effect, it's a group of people he has selected who will select a particular song of your particular choice. And on an anointed day, we will come to church. We will sing the song with you, the initiator of that song. You will introduce it to the audience, and we'll all sing to the glory of God. And one other thing was that we use it as a forum to raise funds for the church, which the church used for its needs. So on the day he called me, I didn't have the strength or courage to tell Akin no, although I've never wanted to leave my cocoon. And then the next thing he said, we are launching in about 2 weeks, so I want you to select your own song and tell me so that we can prepare a program. 2 days after, I called Akin and I told him I have selected my own song, which was one of the songs we just sang, How Great Thou Art. And in my enthusiasm, I busted out singing what I called the solo of that song. And I said, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice, praise the Lord. That the people rejoice, and Akin say, fine, thank you. And I can see nobody's laughing, so nobody knew a mistake had been done. Barely 2 hours later, Akin called me, said, AVM, by the way, that's my name, Air Vice Marshal Ombu, I'm a retired Air Force officer. He said, the song you chose, the first one, it's okay, but the solo you sang is the solo for another song. To God be the glory. Oh my God, I raised my hand and I saw how I had made a fool of myself. So on the particular day we were launching the community hymn singing group, I shared this same story with the church. A lot of people laughed, some even pitied me. And here I am, after the service last night, I went home and I found the very first pamphlet that was published to launch that day. And I looked at the dates. It was 19th of October, 2011. We are all enjoying this beautiful edifice now. At that time, this place was under construction. We did everything in the old sanctuary. We were all happy. We were all robust, full of strength, And by God, barely 5 years after, here we are. Such is life. Aki meant quite a lot to not only us, to everybody who is in this church. On behalf of our group, I will say, Shola, we thank you for everything. May God bless you, bless the children, bless the family, and also, in our own little way, we make sure we stood by you throughout the ordeal. May I also use this opportunity to now read the short tribute which our chairman wrote and has asked me to read here. It says, Aki meant different things to different people. To his social circle, a socialite and a jolly good fellow. To his colleagues, a business executive par excellence. To IBC family, an ardent and dutiful church worker. To Shola, a fantastic husband, friend, and companion. To his lovely children, Jide, Tunde, Tayo, and Michelle, a loving and dutiful father, friend, and a great provider. To us as Community Hymn Singing Group, CHS, an initiator, organizer, and a great contributor. A live wire connecting other brethren within and beyond the church family, and ensuring the objectives of CHS are achieved at all events. To me, a simple and humble brother, friend, and encourager, a silent but extremely efficient worker who will be sorely missed. Aki, you have left an indelible mark in the annals of nature. Our solace is that you've been translated to the world beyond because you have completed your mission and fulfilled your purpose, and the Lord needs you for higher responsibilities, a place we all aspire to be someday. As Christians, we shall not mourn as we are assured that we shall meet again. Our hope is that our toil is over and the roll is called. I hope that when our toil is over and the roll is called, we will not be found wanting and we'll be there in Jesus' name. Sleep on, my dear brother, and sleep well. Thank you.
May I announce that there will be a little addition to the order of service. I've just been informed by the family that the Gideon's International will be giving a presentation to the family and also asking the church for something. Thank you very much.
As we continue in this service, the Lord will be speaking to us from his word. And to this end, we shall be turning to the book of 2 Corinthians, number 2 and number 1. And we are going to read from verses 3 to 7. 2 Corinthians, number 1, verses 3 to 7. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort those who are in any trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounds through Christ. Now, if we are afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effective for enduring the same sufferings which we also suffer. Or, if we are comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope for you is steadfast, because we know that as you are partakers of the sufferings, so also you will partake of the consolation. This is the word of the Lord.
earth is like a mighty sea, so tossed and driven. Billows rise within the heart of every man. Stormed so many times, we leave the heart with questions that you don't need to understand. Just hold his hand.
I don't need to understand. I just need to hold his hand. I don't need to ever ask the reason why. For I know he makes a way through the night and through the day. I don't need to understand. I just need to hold.
People die every day. But when some die, the world jubilates. Whereas when some die, we sorrow. We sorrow as if death is always new. But it's something that actually stays with us, and we know that it will one day happen. This service is one of the hardest services that actually I've ever conducted. When you have to be there to preach after a wonderful friend has passed on. I have prayed for grace, and I know that the Lord God Almighty has heard me. And I pray that all of us here who had contact with our brother will be consoled by the Lord. If at all this message may not be a consolation, I know that the Holy Spirit is here. And may the Spirit of God comfort us and continue to grant us the power to live on. To my dear sister, Deaconess Shola Adeshoko, and the children, and the members of the extended family, if at all he had anybody or anyone like that, because everybody actually was a family to our brother. I want to say that regardless of how deep our personal faith in God and his providence may be, the death of a loved one makes each one of us to feel keenly the personal loss. And I know that in every sense, the aching void that we actually think of concerning the loved one gone will make us to know that grief is not a thing in the abstract, but real, and very real for that matter. I thank God because the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, has it recorded in the Word of God that he wept. He wept. He was a man of emotion. And he wants us to know that weeping is not weakness. But I pray that we will not weep for so long. The Lord would dry away our tears, and the Lord God Almighty will make all things beautiful again. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 116, verse 15, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Precious. Why? Because they have lived well. They have lived well. Not because they have lived long, but they have lived well. You will agree with me that indeed the passing of Enoch was by far better than that of Methuselah. Enoch was not, at the age of 365, he was not, because the Lord took him. Methuselah, at the age of 969, the Bible says, and he died. I pray that indeed our own passing will be glorious. If you're afraid of death, I am sorry for you, because we know that it is inevitable unless Christ comes while we still live. In the book of Job, Job chapter 14, verse 1, the Bible says there that man who is born of woman is of few days and full of trouble. Full of trouble, and yet few days. Some of us would like to live for 100 years. And I know that some have been recorded to have lived for about 150 something years, but they were being sunned in order to receive maybe vitamin C or whatever. And I know that indeed, when you live and then you are now a liability, you know that indeed life is not worth a living at that moment. There are some facts in life. Number one, nobody here present asked to be born.
We were born without consent. And I know that indeed, the life full of trouble, whoever has not passed through trouble has not started living. And we also know that we die against our will. If a brother actually had given up at the time that it said that things were hopeless, he would not have lived for long, that long after he was diagnosed of the sickness. We thank God. Life is certain and death is for sure. But in all these things, I know that the Lord God Almighty is glorified if we happen to know him. Whoever is not in Christ is in much crisis. I stand here to say this. I came from a Muslim home, and I'm proud of my background, but I am rejoicing in the Lord that I got to know Jesus, and Jesus truly is the Son of God. Four facts in life that we don't want to face. The number one thing is, we are afraid to grow old. We don't want to actually say that we are old. Even with gray hair, we want to prove that we are still young. And I know some people who actually have gone for plastic surgery, spending a lot of money in order to look young. And but one thing that is there is that other parts of your body will be telling you that you are old, whether you like it or not. Refresh yourself. Go and farm every muscle. There are some parts that you cannot farm up. And I know that indeed your knees are telling you, old boy, you are old. I found something very touching. And only God, who is forever the same, could say it. In the book of Joshua, chapter 13, verse 1, the Bible tells us that Joshua was old, full of age. And who told him? Again, and the Lord said to him, you are what? You are old. Advance in years. You are old. God will laugh at us and say, look at them. They have the money to actually beautify their face. And if you don't have the money to even beautify your face, I know that a lot of our women are mothers. Will plaster that thing so much to the point that you don't see any wrinkle? Does that actually take away from the fact that you are old? No, it doesn't. Admit the fact. But one thing that is actually sure is this. I pray that you look into the scriptures and see what the writer of Ecclesiastes said to us. In Ecclesiastes chapter 12, it says something about the fact that remember now your creator. In the days when you are still young. Because the time will come when you say you have no pleasure in it. The thing that is there is, let us live for Christ. Let us manage. Let us beautify our inner man. Not the physical thing that actually will end up, as God has said, from dust you came, and to dust it will go. It is important for us to actually know that the Lord wants us to know that he created us like that. will be old. I met my brother 49 years ago. We were very young then, playing football and things like that and whatever. But today I stand before you and confess to you, I am old. A baby born yesterday is how many days old? One day old. Call him new, newborn baby. There have come newer babies after him. The Lord will help us. Another fact that we need to quickly grasp is this. We shall reap whatever we sow. Children of God, my fellow people, it pays to be good. But goodness outside Christ is not goodness, oh. You are putting the cat before the horse. God wants us to claim his love, and then good works should follow. Why? Because our God is good. I boldly say to you today that whatever my brother Akin might have done in life, he did through Christ. He never claimed any credit for whatever he did. He will actually look and say, ah, it is Christ. And is that not what Christ said to us in the book of John chapter 15? Without me, you can do nothing. We may be able to achieve something on our own, but in most cases, it is tainted with self. Whatever we sow, we shall reap. Sometimes we pretend a lot to be good people. We pretend a lot. Church going does not make you a Christian. I know you know that. And I know indeed that, you know, my brother was not just religious. He was a Christian. I'm pointing to this, not because he's there, but we know that indeed we have his body, lifeless body there. He was not just religious, he was a Christian. A lot of people are religious, they come to church, they raise hands up, but they are sowing evil. Evil. If God Almighty will mark iniquity, who will stand? But there are so many who are actually filled with hands of, their hands are filled with blood. We come to church, but God knows who are his. So good, you reap good. You sow evil, so shall it be. In the book of Revelation 22, verse 11, which I love to just read, says that continue to be evil if you are evil, and if you are good, continue to be good. Just continue. Then the following verse says that, hey, I am coming quickly, and my reward is with me, to give unto everyone according to his works. I said, seated now, are you sure you are actually working in towards making heaven? Your mortality is actually glaring at you now. I am a little years older than Akin, and this actually is a bell ringing, calling unto me, saying, hey, who says that this cannot happen to you? But the truth of the matter is, how have I lived? In reality, no preacher can preach your funeral. In reality, actually, it's not hearing us. But we preach our own funeral while we are alive. The lives that we touched, or the lives that actually you ruined, will all stand against you one day. And I pray that indeed, if you're looking for money by all means and you're using human beings to make it, if you call yourself a witch or a wizard, drinking human blood, you vomit all these things. It is important that we know it pays to live in the Lord and to live good. My brother lived a good life. The third thing that we actually do not want to think about, or we hate to think about, is that we must die. We must die. Some don't want to go for funeral services because they don't want to actually come to this realization that one day we'll all go like this. I'll read a passage from John chapter 5. I'll read verses 28 and 29. John 5, 28 and 29. Do not marvel at this. The hour is coming in which all who are in the graves will hear his voice and come forth, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation. Which one will be your own? You will die one day, and after death, judgment. Will you be condemned, or will you resurrect into life? Think about it. Of course, we all know that the judgment day will come when every man's work shall be revealed. Whatever you think you have done in secret will be made open. And I love the ending of the chapter of 12 of Ecclesiastes. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is man's all. For God will bring every work into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. Judgment day will come. We shall stand before the throne of God. And who will be the judge? Jesus Christ. No other prophet. Call Jesus a prophet. Call him a teacher. Call him son of Joseph. You will know that day, that he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The one who sits on the throne to judge everyone. I pray that in the service, you come to realize the fact that, hey, when you die, the whole thing is ascended. Oh, no more chance for repentance. What is needed? Do today. Don't postpone it till tomorrow. As far as I know, with the Lord God Almighty, who sits on the throne, who is the Lord of his church, I can live well. He was rich in everything, material things, but not in any way did he push it to his face. In spiritual things, wonderfully rich. May God allow us to end that way when Christ will actually be our Lord. In Jesus' name.
I actually did not know that Oga would be able to hold this long. I was very scared and been praying for him that the Lord would give him strength to be able to do this. They've been together for a very, very long time, and I came to join them in their friendship. This Olivet thing is always bubbling in them. Well done, sir. May God strengthen you and abide with you in Jesus' name. May we take together the chorus, Domwens, you are the Lord that healeth me. You are the Lord my healer. You sent your word and you heal my disease. And we will pray together. And the family members will be upstanding as we take this chorus.
You are the Lord.
Let's go.
That he led me. You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
Let's take it together.
You are the Lord. You are the Lord that healeth me. You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
Yes, Lord, our Father in heaven, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today, what shall we say? That you do all things well. That when you, the Lord, our God, does whatever you like in the heavens, we have no choice but to respond in faith that you are the Lord. So we have come, though with a heavy heart, though with pains and aches, though with frets and worries and pains of loss and grief of departure of our beloved uncle, friend, husband, father, and associate. We are grateful for the power of your word which you have sent to us, which brings comfort. It brings encouragement, the inspired word of God that challenges each and every one of us that is left behind to continue in this race of commitment, dedication, and faithfulness to you. Lord, we are grateful for this. We are grateful, Heavenly Father, for the quality life that your son lived while he was here. Thank you for the lives that he touched. His lovely wife, his wonderful children, his friends, family members, well-wishers, the organizations he worked for, people, places, impressions and legacies which your son left behind. They continue to speak as this lingers in our hearts, as a memorial. Lord God Almighty, and a tribute to his life and his time. Take glory, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, at this time we ask for your comfort again and again. for his family, that you will comfort them. You are the father to the fatherless. You are the husband to the widow. As the reality of this demise sets in on a daily basis, nostalgic feelings, reminiscences of lives lived together, moments of joy, pains, and aches shares continue, Lord God Almighty, to surface, you will bring your comfort. When Lord God Almighty, all of us, friends, well-wishers, associates, church members, will have departed and go to our various homes and places of destination. And Auntie Shola and the children and the family will be alone to continue to savour the reality of this loss. Father, bring your comfort. When Lord God Almighty, the organizations he worked for and people he interacted with, onshore, offshore, physical, spiritual, siblings, groups, and various formations that your sons was involved, clubs, social lives, and this reality will continue to nag. And many a times they refuse to go so quickly because it is real. Father, bring your comfort. In the name of the resurrected Jesus, we ask for your protection for the family. We ask, Lord, for your abiding presence. We ask for the comforting power of the Holy Spirit by day and by night. And Lord God Almighty, you, helper of the helpless, will continue to abide with them and minister to their needs physically, spiritually, and in every way possible in the name of Jesus Christ. God of heaven and earth, we pray that you will sustain them and you will take care of them. And those things that are left unfinished and undone, for no one can finish everything, Lord God Almighty, you will take care of them and make all things perfect and well to the praise and glory of your name, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we ask that you cover the children and the wife and the siblings with the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ, that no evil shall behold you. No powers of darkness shall be attracted to you. That principality and minions and demons of this world will not afflict you. The sons of wickedness will not exert upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God of heaven, I pray, after this time out, you begin to make adjustments, Lord God Almighty, to life without, Lord God, the breadwinner, the father, the friend, and the best that you have given to the family. Lord, you be there for them and fill the gap. You minister to their life. You minister to their spirit. You minister to the family. You minister to everything that he has left behind in the name of Jesus Christ. That Lord God Almighty, it shall not be that after the death of your son, further evils will encroach upon the home in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, we pray for each and every one of us. Grant your healing. Grant us your deliverance. Father, touch our physical body. Grant us long life. Grant each and everyone good health. In the name of Jesus Christ. The word of God revealed to us in the book of Habakkuk chapter 2. He said, Lord, revive your work. Revive your work in the midst of the years. Remember mercy in times of wrath. Father, we ask, O God, that you heal your people. Heal us, we pray, in the name of Jesus Christ. And by your grace divine, put an end to untimely death. Lord God Almighty, in our rank and in our files, and Lord, in your church, in the name of the resurrected Jesus, spare us from pestilence that destroys at noonday and wickedness that takes away at night. That Lord God Almighty, we shall no longer be cut off in our primes, in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive healing today. Receive healing today. Spirit, soul, body, receive healing in the name of Jesus. In the head, receive healing. In the neck, in the tooth, in the eyes, in the ears, receive healing in the name of Jesus. In the neck, in the chest, in the intestine, in the body, in the knee, in the legs, receive healing in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the Lord our healer. Jehovah Rapha is your name. You heal our diseases. Lord God Almighty, we pray, heal us and spare us from untimely death. In the name of the resurrected Jesus, that we will live long, will fulfill the number of our years, we will fulfill destiny and give glory to you. That our life will count for you, that our life will add value to you and to the society, that we will not live in vain. That, Lord, you hold our hands, even Lord God Almighty, through to eternity, in the name of Jesus Christ. I commit Ikoyi Baptist Church unto you. And Lord, you will take care of your church. You minister to your people. You be with our Father in the Lord, a pastor and his team, and every member of this church, Lord God Almighty, you will comfort them. You will strengthen them. Lord God, you be with the Dangote group and minister to them. Lord God, you will abide with them. That everything that your son has done in his earthly life will continue to be a legacy of goodwill and good things in the name of Jesus. We pray for Ikoyi Club and every organization and all the parachurch ministries that your son was involved in while he was here. Father, you will take care of them. Lord, we appreciate you today. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. Teach us also to number our days. Teach us to number our years. Teach us to put our hearts and apply it unto your wisdom. That we will live, O God, one day at a time for your glory and praise and honor. In the name of Jesus Christ. Again, Lord, we pray for the family. Take care of them. Abide with them. Minister to them. Fight for them. Defend them. Protect them. Lord God Almighty, grant them journey mercies. Take care of every area of their interest. That, Lord God Almighty, the demise of your son will not be a perpetual pain. But your presence, Heavenly Father, will mitigate every form of grief and ache in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless your name. Take glory forever. Jesus Christ's matchless name, I pray, and everyone say, amen.
Good morning, everyone. I'm here to give a vote of thanks, and I will begin by thanking, most importantly, the Almighty God for the fact that we are here today. Our Lord has been faithful. I thank him for his grace and his faithfulness. We remain faithful through all that has happened. This has been a journey that started over 2 years ago. And through that, we have prayed. This is not what we prayed for, but regardless, our faith remains strong. And for that, we must continue to give thanks. I would like to secondly thank my dad. I want to thank you, Daddy, for the love you showed to us, to your wife, and to your three sons. I thank you, Daddy, because your love was always showered on us in bounds. You made several sacrifices, many that we know of and some that I've only come to hear about recently, and for that I say thank you. Mommy, I want to say thank you to you personally and on behalf of Jide and Tayo. This is a deep, heartfelt appreciation, Mom, and we've said this several times over the course of the last 2 years, but I want you to know it and I want to say it for the church to hear that we are thankful. I don't know how my mom has gone through the last 2 years. It has been difficult, I'm not going to lie, and she will attest to that. Whilst we were in London on several occasions, when she was taking care of my dad, Jide, Tayo, or myself would ask her that, you know what, Mom, for today, don't do anything, just take a rest, because we can see that this is a draining task. And on any day when I took the lead, I can assure you, and anyone who has cared for anyone who has been a carer will attest to this, it was physically and emotionally draining on just the one day. My mom did this for 2 years, unending, nonstop. It is a task that I don't know how she found the strength, but I know that her strength came through her faith in God, in our Lord, and ultimately from her love for my dad, which has inspired me throughout the last 2 years. I wish and I pray that for all of us, that we will love our spouses and our families as she loved my dad and he loved her. So, Mommy, thank you very much. It is impossible in the time that we are here to thank everyone. So let me just say this, because I can't start naming names. I will name names and call categories, and I'll keep it brief, Pastor, I promise. But let me say this. Throughout all that has happened over the last 2 years, spiritually, financially, physically, and emotionally, it would have been impossible to be where we are today, 2 years down the line, without the help of all of you who are here, all your prayers, and the help and support of many who are not here. So without calling names, let me tell you this. I did not say it would have been difficult. I said it would have been impossible. So let me say this from my family on behalf of all of us. Thank you very much. This is deep and heartfelt, and I mean every inch of that from my family. Thank you so much. I would like to thank Ikoyi Baptist Church. There's no competition amongst churches, or there shouldn't be, but we are proud of you as a church. You have become more than a church, you are our family. We've served in this church for over 2 decades, and in that time, we have come to know so many of you in ways that goes beyond friendship. It is really at a family level. Pastor, I thank you very much for fostering this. We are grateful. I want to thank the pastors, the officiating ministers who are here today. I'm sure Pastor will identify them later. The choir, the orchestra, the Citadel of Praise, Audiovisual Department, WMS, thank you very much for helping us to give my dad a fitting funeral. We really are grateful. Thank you very much. I want to say special thanks to the ushers and to the community hymn singing group. You know that you were a special buddy for my dad. He cared a lot about you. He was excited when he was serving as an usher. When he started the community hymn singing, Jiditayo and I were abroad at the time, but his passion for it, I called my mom and said, "Mom, are we getting any money out of this, or is this just Popsi's passion?" But he was so passionate about it. It made us really proud. So thank you very much. I also want to thank Alhaji Aliko Dangote and the Dangote Group. This is not the thanks that will come out of thanking his employers generally. Alhaji Aliko Dangote and I have spoken several times over the course of the last 2 years. Those calls from Alhaji were not duty bound. They were not out of obligation. We know he is not a stranger to any of us, and we know how busy he is. And so those calls, those emails from Engineer Joe Makoju as well, and the whole group, we could tell that they were heartfelt, they were out of a sincere appreciation for my father. And for that, sir, and for your group, I say thank you very much. I also want to thank West African Portland Cement. He left about 15 years ago, to a competitor. But even through that, you have been friends to him, you have been loyal to him. And for that, I want to thank you. Ikoyi Club 1938, his social life, the tennis section in particular, the Metropolitan Club, and Table 7 thereof. Oba Akiolu, I've seen your delegation here, and I thank you very much. Thank you to all of you. Now, let me come to my dad's family and friends. Again, for all of you, I physically could not start to thank you, and I wouldn't know where to begin. My mom calls while we were abroad, whilst I've been here, she will call on one day and say, "This person has called, this person has given this, this person has said this," and she has a list, and Jiri and I and Taya, we've split the list amongst ourselves, who to call to say thank you. And I don't think we're up to halfway through. if we started now, it would be impossible. But again, please take this from the family, from his friends, from the extended family as well, that we are thankful. All your visits, all your calls uplifted my dad in the time he was ill. It brought smiles to his face, and he was grateful, even when he struggled to show or to express that thanks. You could tell, and you could tell from his countenance, that he was grateful, and so we thank you. One thing that the illness, and it's difficult to thank God for an illness in a sense, but this illness gave my dad, let me put it this way, my dad was a fighter. When he was first diagnosed, he was given, and many don't know this, he was given six months to live. He fought that. And each time he went to the doctors, they were surprised because the scans they saw didn't match the physical appearance of my dad or his physical ability. And he fought through all that. But what that afforded us was the opportunity for his family, for his friends, for his church, for his employers, to show him love. It is a regret often expressed by many that they didn't get the chance to show love to the people they cared for before they passed away. Well, let me say this. All of us and all of you here have shown him that love. You have cared for him. You have been there for him. And so you can rest assured that he is grateful that you have expressed that love. So thank you so much. Like I said, I can't start naming names, but I must in certain exceptions. Auntie Rolake, I want to thank you particularly. In your silent, subtle, caring way, you have shown love to us, and not just love, your support, your being there for us, and your whole family being there for us has been, we can't show enough appreciation. So thank you very much. Uncle Jimmy and the Shoebos, you have helped in increasing our own faith. Your prayers have been uplifting and strengthening for us. And we will continue to be grateful. I want to also say this. It's easy sometimes to not thank the people, you know, those lower than us, many people that you think are servants or beneath us. They're not beneath us. They're people like the drivers, the carers, Mr. Elijah, Momodu, Ahmed, all these people who have made caring for my dad so much easier, and who I know have become family, who have shown true love. For all of you, I say thank you. Thank you very much. I just want to pray that the Lord, our God, will meet all of you at your respective points of need. Thank you very much.
Before I invite Architect Oduwale to come and give the presentation from the Gideons International, I want to say that I want to thank the ministers. We have the ministers from the Methodist Church. I know that you know about it. Oh, you don't? Yes, you do. And I know that my brother who is seated there is actually part of us. Thank you so much for coming. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Reverend Babalola, Reverend Oyeniyi, Reverend Mrs. Bosun Adegwega, and of course, Reverend Dr. Eddie Kay. We thank you so much for coming. And I know that the convention president called me and said that he called in order to show his condolence to the church and also to the family. And I was asking him, "Would you like to come and be part of this service?" And he said, "He will come, but we'll send a representative to come and join us." And that is actually why you have Reverend Dr. Emmanuel Awotunde here, representing the Nigerian Baptist Convention president, who is in Abuja at this present moment. And he will be saying the closing prayer and the benediction. And I know that choir, we have thanked you, Abby. I think you mentioned them. The Sister of Praise, the orchestra, we thank you so much. Instrumentalists, thank you so much for all that you have actually rendered. And may I say that everyone here present, sincerely speaking, we thank you for your time and for your coming. The Lord bless you. May I now invite Architect Oduwale to do the presentation. And naturally, we don't ask for offering when we have a program like this. But the Gideon International will be asking for your donation towards the printing of Bibles. And I want to please ask that you respond positively to this.
Thank you, Pastor. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there, but water the earth and make the plants bold, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, without accomplishing what I desire, and without fulfilling the purpose for which I sent it. That is the word of God. Good afternoon, church. I bring you greetings from the Gideon's International, an association of Christian businessmen and professionals who proclaim the good news of the risen Lord Jesus Christ. We do this by personal witnessing, and as so many of you know, by the distribution of scriptures in all the traffic lanes of life. We distribute scriptures in schools, colleges, universities, hospitals, police formations, military institutions, and lately, thinking of putting scriptures on aircrafts. We distribute, or since its inception, we have distributed over 2 billion Bibles worldwide. In Nigeria, where Gideon started in 1964, we've distributed 64.1 million scriptures in Nigeria. We have membership in 200 countries of the world, and we've translated scriptures into 97 languages so that the word of God may go around and people will be able to have access to the word of God. One Bible like this placed in the hotel would minister to about 2,300 people over a period of 6 years. We withdraw those scriptures after 6 years and take them to prisons so that prisoners could have access to the word of God. For those who would have loved to be members of the Gideons and have not been able to, especially clergymen, a new idea has come forward, and they are now being referred to as Friends of the Gideons. because clergymen are not allowed to be members of the Gideons. But now, you can now be friends of the Gideons, so you can help us with your prayers and also with your funds. Thank you. We have a program called the Gideon's Card Program, and it has three components. We have what we call the immemorial or in memory program, which is what we're doing now. We encourage people who've lost their loved ones to provide scriptures in memory of the departed one, so that we can distribute these scriptures all over the world, not just in Nigeria alone. And that's why we have this part of the service right now. We also have in honor or recognition. If you have a new baby, we encourage you to distribute scriptures for the arrival of that baby, naming. We also do it for birthdays, graduation, marriages, and promotions. So next time you have a promotion, don't spend all the money entertaining your friends. Remember to donate some to the Gideons so that we can distribute scriptures on your behalf. Then the third part is thinking of you. If you have a friend or a family member who is in distress or who has a problem, you can encourage them by donating scriptures on their behalf. So today we are appealing to you, because every scripture we buy with this fund will be distributed all over the world. And we don't take any administrative charges. Every nickel, every kobo will be used for printing scriptures. Aki was Gideon friendly. He supported the Gideons in his lifetime, because I personally collected checks from him during his birthdays to buy scriptures. So thank you very much, as I would like to take more of your time. It would be very kind of you. And I will present a copy of the Bible to the family so that they will remember this occasion. Thank you very much.
May I invite all members of the Gideons and their auxiliary to please come quickly and take these bags around. If you want to donate something for them, please kindly do so. Thank you very much. I will continue the announcement at this time. We forgot two important people, and that is the pianist and the organist. Please forgive us. When we say something about choir, we actually have you in mind that we have put you together. And thank you, Brother Lanry. Thank you, Brother Morofola, Kayode Morofola. Thank you so much. Yesterday was a great night. We spent about close to 4 hours for the service, and we were not tired. Thank you so much, everybody, for coming. May I announce that the interment will take place at Vaults and Gardens, but please, only the family and close friends are invited for this service. That is the interment. The rest of us, we are told to actually go to Harbour Point where the reception will take place. And may I also announce that please, Deaconess Shola Adeshokan will not be going home. So don't go home. She will go to the reception area to see friends and well wishers there. Thank you very much for this, and the Lord bless you. And I pray that your visit after this service, that is after today, will not just be abruptly cut off. You can still visit and pray with the family. But more so, we want our sister to have time to really rest. At the time that our brother Akin passed on, we had really, really bombarded her with our visits, and we thank God for that. It's part of our culture in Africa, and we thank God for that, that people rally around you and show their love to you. I lost my brother 2 years ago in America. Even the neighbors did not come. I was surprised. The next door neighbor did not even come. We have a rich culture that sometimes we can take it overboard. So please. And I must confess also that we have planned something that our sister Deaconess Shola Adeshokan will run away from Nigeria for a while so that she can have time to really recuperate. God bless you all for this that you have shown. And have I forgotten anything for announcements? Have I? Thank you. We will at this time rise for the closing prayer and benediction to be said by Dr. Awotunde, who is representing the convention president.
Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we give you thanks for this opportunity to celebrate the life of one of your servants. Father, be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank you for all what he has been able to achieve while on earth. We say unto you, to you be the glory in Jesus' name. Once again, we commit the widow and the children unto you. Lord of glory, uphold them. Grant them the fortitude to bear the exit of your servant in the name of Jesus. We ask, the banner of the Lord will cover you. Throughout your lifetime, you enjoy the best of the Lord, and you will live under his umbrella in the name of Jesus. And for our church, Ikoyi Baptist Church, God of comfort, comfort this assembly. We ask, in your own way, continue to prosper the ministry of this church, and let the blood of the Lamb cover every members of this church in the name of Jesus. And unto friends and other extended family, God of grace, grant your grace unto these people. Empower them to count their days and help them to live for you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. To you be the glory. And Lord, unto you, who is able to keep these people from falling, I commit them. Unto you, who is able to empower them to live life of impact, I commit them. Let the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide with these people from this moment and even forevermore.
The recessional will take place almost the same way we proceeded for this service. The ministers will be in front, the pallbearers will follow, and then the family will follow before the other members of the church may actually go with us as we proceed, as we actually go to the cemetery for the interment. Thank you very much once again. God bless you. God bless you.
The recessional hymn is on page 4 of our program. When the roll is called up yonder.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning brings eternal bright and fair. When the seraph shall gather over on the other shore, and the rolling call of yonder, I'll be there. When the rolling call of yonder, when the rolling call of yonder. Up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection shed, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road call up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our walk on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
When the roll is called,
when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.